Andy Selick in 2010 went to vote in Minnesota wearing a Tea Party t-shirt. He was twice stopped by a poll worker from voting, and on the third try, he was finally allowed to vote, but his name and address was taken down for potential prosecution. He filed a First Amendment lawsuit against Joe Manske and other government officials in Minnesota, alleging that Minnesota's broad ban on all political apparel at the polling place violates the First Amendment. The law at issue in this case is Minnesota's Section 211B11, which prohibits voters from wearing any political badge, button, or other insignia at the polling place. Minnesota promulgated an Election Day policy that says political includes groups with recognizable political views, such as the Tea Party, MoveOn.org, and so on. If a poll worker thinks that someone is voting while wearing political apparel, then that person writes down the name and address of that voter for potential prosecution. Minnesota thinks of a violation of this law as a petty misdemeanor, which can be enforced by fines of up to $5,000. So the government can restrict speech that is not protected by the First Amendment. For example, things like true threats, obscenity, the court has not given First Amendment protections to. But in other arenas, if the government wants to restrict speech that is protected by the First Amendment, it needs to show why its regulations are justified and why those First Amendment restrictions are justified. The best argument for Minnesota Voters Alliance was just that this law is so broad that it is unconstitutional under the First Amendment. A law is overbroad if it covers substantially more speech than is necessary to further the government's interests. The Supreme Court has said that the First Amendment recognizes that free speech is so important that we don't want the government to pass an overbroad law that stifles the rights of people to express themselves in fear that they might be prosecuted under a certain law. In essence, this law creates a political speech free zone at the polling place, and political speech free zones are inconsistent with the free speech clause of the First Amendment. The best argument for Minnesota is that Burson versus Freeman, which actually upheld a 100-foot buffer zone on active campaigning, might also extend to a law preventing passive wearing of any political speech at the polling place, where Minnesota relies on the polling place as a non-public forum in arguing that it's reasonable to ban all political messages at the polling place. A public forum is a forum that has traditionally been used for expressive activity. For example, a public sidewalk is a public forum. There's also a non-public forum in which the government opens up its property for only a limited purpose. The government argues that because the polling place is a non-public forum, any restrictions on speech need be reasonable and viewpoint neutral. The potential impact of this case is quite large. 9 other states have similar laws to Minnesota, so ruling in this case could affect laws in 10 different states, and it would affect not just voters wearing Tea Party t-shirts, but it would also affect voters who want to wear shirts that say ACLU, NAACP, or even Me Too at polling places in their state.